Fishing out in the water for 4 hours and then came back and hunted in hot 12-foot high corn. And just birds.
Oh.
But at the end of it, I thought the guy was going to have to carry me. I really gave up. He thought so too. I mean, I thought I had to stop and just, I couldn't move my legs.
Good thing you didn't have to carry moose out of the woods.
But that was good.
Restricted step push hands. First thing I want to just practice by way of kind of warming up is a really simple lesson, which for me is based on a lesson Avi would teach. So I want you to try and work through my defenses, right? Figure out, like, solve what I'm doing. So this often is what happens. Push hands, you know, of course, in restricted step, we might be stepping as well. But what I want the practice to be is, during this solving and trying things out, don't forget to try just pushing. It's amazing that it's called push hands and people forget to push. And they get all tied up in, oh my God, and this, and get her, and it's like, oh, maybe I should just, you know, it's like the person that's waiting for the locksmith, and then they're like, you know, maybe if I just, oh, look, it's unlocked, you know. Like, you might just try that. And so, for a warm-up, what I want to do is what we just did, which is describe that one person is just trying to solve all the different things. Basically, it usually means they're trying to deal with the arms and hands. And then if it was you doing this, then at some point, just try to push, right? And it doesn't mean that you have to solve this and get the push to here. It could mean that I just try a push. Because very frequently what people do is they just think, if you can just throw a series of strikes at me, they think what they have to do is deal with each biplane coming at King Kong before they can do whatever it is to Fay Wray. And I have to realize that as you're trying to push me, I don't have to just solve this, solve that, and hope, pause, that one day I'll be here and try this. I can just remember that at some point, if I can feel Mark through all this, try pushing Mark. Okay? So that's the warm-up. So I'll have you watch the warm-up first, so each of you guys will do it. Just establish who is just creating a bunch of chaos, and who's trying to solve it.
Okay, chaos.
And Ken's just trying to solve each thing. So get into that mode of just trying to solve it, because essentially what this requires a breaking of a trance. And it'd be nice to look at it from the outside and say, well, that's not me. I know to push the guy. And yet, if you watch tape of you, you'll probably see you're in the trance. So this is a practice of breaking the trance, but it stems from an ability to recognize the trance, which stems from an ability to admit that, hey, I get in the trance. And so it can help to see it from the outside and say, oh, you know what, I kind of, like I was asking, if you see yourself on tape, you can start to see, oh, I just get into this blocking, solve this, solve that. Instead of saying, hey, I'd like you to just push it. And then at some point, just decide, see if there's a push that'll work. Right? And we're kind of treating this as fixed step now because it's just one thing we're trying to address, not can then end step well. So that trance break is basically, let me just try the door. If you're in contact with them, knocking the biplanes down, you may have enough information to know
that you can't do
that.
Grab,
you can actually feel,
I don't know,
that there's a good shot of the push working, as opposed to this blatant guess.
Can you grab like this? Is that
for a moment? You can, yeah.
Okay. I'll keep on.
But generally, you can grab for the duration of the technique.
Let's start at the beginning.
I'm trying to
Yeah, there you go. So even you can see Ken's actually distracted by his arms now. Huh?
What?
Oh. I could just see Ken was actually distracted by your arms. You know.
Oh.
So often when I spar, set up the spar, I'll do this, and then good, you're starting to spar. As soon as you can't imagine bothering me without doing something about my arm. And the moment you do something about my arm, I use that energy. And people will know it, and they still can't. I'll do this, and they still can't. Just they have to deal with it.
And my mind is focused on completely.
They have to deal with that, which I don't agree. But that's I say have to because that's how they feel and that's how they respond. But and I'll it's like dangling keys for the baby, you know. Just do that, and then even if they know they're faster than me, they'll still touch it before they come in, you know. And then as soon as they just touching it. Boom, you know, that's what helped me do whatever I'm doing. And if he does that and then throws a shot, that's what I'm using to check his shot, right? And so I just floated out there in this Tai Chi way. Like, I'm not here where he feels my feet when he checks it. I'm just here. And the moment he touches it, you know, I have my shot. And it's, you know, and I'll explicitly teach it, and people like, got it, and then it'll be unconscious, they'll still touch it when they come in, you know. And so in a similar way, people are just, I know I'm not supposed to, but I still feel like I have to deal with all of your arms before I get to the promised land of your chest where I can push. And it's not true. And so it's a very simple reminder, which can be helpful if it works for you when you're being cheered or coached. Just push. Like, it's two words.
Yeah.
It's just a simple reminder. Oh, don't get confused.
Just.
You know? Like, there's 1,000 drones and 1 queen. Stay focused. Just push. You know, like, there's, you know what I mean? And that can work for you. Just like, oh, I'm just trying to deal with all these things. No, you're trying to push. There's not all these things. So you have to push or go. Right? And so it can be a helpful thing if your team will say, I am suggesting just push, but whatever you determine is fine by me.
Can I ask a question?
Please.
I meant to ask this one. He's much stronger than I am, you know, and with in his arms and stuff, and that's, but he's tight. So, mm-hmm. How do I have a hard time? I get tired trying to.
His tightness means that when you're touching him, you're able to move his feet.
Yeah.
Oh. That's a handle.
Right?
Okay. Because I tire myself out finding his strength.
Let me ask you a question. What percentage of his waking day is he as strong as he can be?
As strong as he can
be? Yeah, let's say 16 hours a day he's awake.
Let me say 8 hours.
Okay, so half the time.
Yeah.
That's fair. What percentage of your waking day are you as smart as you are?
When I'm awake all day.
Oh, so?
Okay.
Let's not try and use your strength against his strength. Use something else. When his strength tires, he has less of what he counts on. Mm. What, are you going to get less smart during the match?
Yeah. No, but
his strength get played out, right? Let him use that. Use that to feel his feet, and then he will slowly see his levels of what he counts on diminish. But you will be as smart at the end of the match as at the beginning.
But what if he's using good strength and good technique?
That's good. Trout
fish?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Set your drag.
Yeah. Make him pay for the strength.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep, for sure.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. I mean, you are strong. It's really, I can feel, you know, that strong.
Nobody mentioned Ken Smarts at all in the whole conversation. He's just like, are we going to get to that?
should he now be following me?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay.
Just give him lots to deal with. Move your arms here, try this, try pulling, try this type of circle, try different speeds, keep bothering them with your hands, even if you're not particularly pushing. So even here at twice you tried to push him.
Yep.
But in each case you tried to get rid of his arms and just push him fast.
First.
So you're basically just trying to rapidly do the whole thing. The idea is from wherever you are, just push him. Particularly if he's stiff or strong, you have a conduit to his feet. And it might very well be that you go into his chest. There's nothing wrong with that. I just don't want you to think that that's the job here. Deal with this, and even if you're coming out of my chest, I feel like I gotta deal with that, right? On my chest, on my belly, whatever. I gotta deal with that before anything else. Mark said, push him. I'm like, yeah, but let me get rid of it. That's all my thinking. Instead of just saying, maybe I can just push. Okay? Maybe I can just push. Maybe I can push. Maybe I can push. Maybe I can push. So this is just patty cake. And it's like, remember, it's push hands. But people get, and I've seen people, like national champions, this is all they're doing. And it's interesting, it's cool martial skill.
Yeah,
I can check, I can block, and I can do all this stuff, but it's like, oh, I can also, I'm trying to get him. I'm playing against him, not his arms. Right? That doesn't translate directly to great self-defense skills, is in self-defense skills, there's no ref and there's no rules, and me going here, you know, is exactly when he stabs me in the temple. So I do need to respect the arms in a self-defense situation differently. But the rules and the refs allow me to just challenge his balance. And so now, if you watch me play, you can keep befuddling me. I'm gonna only, I won't have a trance. I'll just have a single-minded focus on balance. You should feel like I don't care about your arms.
Yeah.
I just have your body through your arms. Now, if your arms are softer, it's harder for me to feel your body through your arms. See? Like that. Nice. Feel okay?
Yeah.
I'll play with you.
No, I'm sorry.
We'll just warm you up a little. So Ed, I want you to tell Mark if he ends up in a trance. Right, so we're just playing. And we could do it restricted since that's the training. Thing to tell him that's not a full sentence.
Push, or go to the, or snap out of it. That's right.
All right, yeah. I was gonna say a little.
That's good. Nice.
I would say a little house music, which is not about a trance, but that's just me. Easy, you didn't have to step. You just gave up. You gotta, every point you save, it's the last point that you have to recover later when you're tired. So, don't give me one easy point. Run out the bases, hustle. That time was good, the last two, no. No, lazy step. Think of, I can't really see that. Think of this, okay, so you feel like you shouldn't be coming towards me, that's fair. Maybe, right? So think of that lead foot as the weapon. As soon as it goes back here, the weapon's holstered. You know, that's not deployed. Right? This, it's just the idea of coming at me, it just seems ridiculous. This doesn't seem fun, but it's doable. So you could think of that leg as, do you ever want your weapon on the other side of you from the target?
Yeah.
You know. One more time. Don't change the feet. Don't change the feet. A lean. If you give me your weight to bear, I can throw you. Try pushing.
You put in the shoulder. You know.
Sure.
Ow.
Bump.
I
was so glad that you laughed.
I've been waiting 3 weeks to go back up and take a picture with that cow.
You trying to practice with cows?
It's just a Chinese term for what we did.
Oh.
Sacred in India. Okay. Questions?
I have one question.
Please.
That's fine, sorry.
Okay, so somebody's cheering you on and they say push, you're the ref. Do you stop that? Do you stop that coaching? Or?
Well, it doesn't sound like coaching, it just sounds like. It
says like
cheers. It's like go get them and swing the bat and hit it. It doesn't sound like specific coaching
okay. To
me.
You get a really trained eye over there.
You know, somebody just says push, you know.
It's pretty generic.
Yeah, trance push or just push, you know.
Yeah.
Try pushing. Doesn't particularly sound like coaching to me. So,
like breaking out of that.
That's what I'm saying. If you have people cheering for you that are not trained to do it, it doesn't become helpful. It's distracting. It's a full sentence.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or
after
you have their voice, it's after the fact. You need to know somebody you can count on, and that voice works, you know, to just to increase the odds of it doing what you want.
Right.
the general idea, it's nice to have supporters, people cheering, that's great. But I'd rather have somebody that's gonna tell me something specific that's my problem or a challenge or very specific and helpful thing. How often, how loud, that's what I want.
I have two questions. One, is that like, when he's using the shoulder, is that like the shoulder stroke, you know?
Yeah.
Form?
Mm-hmm.
And that's all right, that's legal. And,
mm-hmm. Yep.
The other thing I noticed, he sneaks a hand under your arm,
mm-hmm.
against your shoulder. What technique is that?
I'm not sure what you mean. So.
He goes like this.
Yeah, that's
well,
right.
He can do that. That's what I mean. The horse is mane. You can do that. A lot of times I get in the habit of from a different form, but it's not actually.
It's interesting that you pointed that out. That's what I was thinking about going over tonight. So that's pretty cool.
Oh.
That's the thing you came up with.
Yeah.
Did you have a question to
offer?
No.
It's legal, but to stretch the other one is not.
But it's almost like grasping the sparrow's tail.
Mm-hmm. So, what I was thinking that we would work on is this idea. This often happens if I come in and he closes this because he doesn't want it to touch him. But I could also just go here, right? Whether we're touching or not. And so, coming under to the elbow and leading that elbow across. Right? So, that practice is what I wanted to work on, and then I'll show you a little bit more with it too. So the practice is to come across to the elbow, and then we want to lead that elbow across him like a Mona Lisa smile. You know what I mean by that?
What, I didn't know the Mona Lisa smile. No.
Slanted?
Oh.
Pretty much a straight line, but it's a smile.
Okay.
Right? And that means it has a down, an over, and a little up, right?
And
what I want to do is not just grab and yank. I want to lead when he's doing a thing. And that requires that in order to buy space, I don't lean and lose my footing and tip over, but I control that as he leads that I come off. And Mark will tell you that I'm just, it's essentially friction. I'll do it on this side so the camera can see too. It's essentially friction. I'm not doing this and turning his inner elbow up and lifting my shoulder. I'm not turning his hand this way. Push. I'm leading this over. And then I'm making space for it to come by. If I don't, we might end up locking him. And that's not what I'm trying to do. So I might, especially in restricted step, see a little space here. I might go a little bit longer so that I can shift and turn more to clear that. And often what you'll see is this followed by this. So I'm 1-2, like in the form, 1-2. So we'll 1-2, especially if he doesn't quite go. So the practice is connect to the elbow and here. And we can practice this way. I come in and he deflects me. So I rotate. Notice I don't do this. Mark just pushes me now, right? You know, I'm keeping my stability. So I come in, he deflects. I find, notice I'm not hooking with the fingers and grabbing. Just light, over, down, over, and up. So if we were to graph that smile, it's a little down, over, a little up. It's not down, up. It's not down, over, up, like a U. It's a sly smile.
What's the diagonal orientation?
It's basically
so it's
where my arm wants to go by turning my hips. It could change if I'm shifting into it or out of it or taking a step. So that can change. And if I go really deep, so if he's traveling this way instead of more here, it's much easier to kind of slip. If I go over here, it's harder to slip, but it's easier for me to turn this into this game. See me? I'm up and tight. So you push, 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 push. That's what I want to be able to do. Okay? let's all just try that as a drill, I guess. So push in, get deflected, find it, pause, and then think through the smile. I'll just do it with this, yeah. And then we'll just switch partners, you know. So I'll do it to you, I guess, the first one. Mm-hmm. So I come in and you deflect me with this hand.
Deflect with this hand?
Yeah.
This way?
Yeah, right. Just, you don't like what I'm doing, so yeah, that's it. And I'll just start this on me. It's easier if it has a base, if the hand that you're laying is touching.
And then you're going to take this elbow.
Yeah, so you just, in other words, that's an easy way for me to end up there. You clear me there,
mm-hmm.
Right? Because you don't want that generally. Yeah. So. And then
I'm leading going on first. You know,
you'll notice that
right.
If this was kung fu, you'd expect, you know, this kind of energy.
Yeah.
But no, it's
right
there's a friction
to the end,
and then
uh-huh.
you're led. And particularly if you push a little here, which seems like the time for to do it, you did a defense and then you attack.
And you always do it against the
right. Just
leg,
focus on this.
Oh.
Yeah, for now. And then I want to lead that
okay.
off the line. And you could see where I could be bringing it into some other painful stuff.
Yeah.
So one more time, you deflect, and then push, and I lead.
Oh.
Right, so I'll try it.
Oh, I see. I should be more in there.
Okay, so I'm going.
Yeah, you're just coming in to push. Right. Good. Let's show you. And I slower.
That worked.
Deflect.
Uh-huh. And so I'm going here.
So notice that if you reach too, try and reach all the way around. Like you're.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you want to keep yourself square, vertical, aligned, not tight, not overly turned, trying to get in here. So you have your connection. Yeah.
That's really
nice. Yeah. Nice first one there.
Oh.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, so I'm here.
That's
wrestling. Lead my elbow.
Okay.
And we're doing whatever we're
doing.
Try to go push it lower. That way I deflect you easier to the outside. And then wait for me to push. I'm just going to lead. It's easy to think about my problem. I just lead my elbow.
Down like that. Okay.
I have to feel before I do anything.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. Coming lower just so it's more.
I don't want to put it through the beginning. Put this in.
So yeah. So if you were to actually push me.
Sure.
Wasn't as good. I could have. I think it was if you had my
if you have your way forward, it's easier because when you do it you can shift back to buy some space and time. Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was. Because the movement was
yep.
The thing I would say. I think you don't have the proper leverage when you go on the elbow.
The elbow
and the elbow bends and
yeah, that makes sense. You don't have to reach all the way around. That's not a hook. It's just a
reach a lot too when I watch it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's see what thank you, sir.
If we learn one thing, that if you snag the elbow, you don't get the proper leverage.
What do you mean? It changes a little bit.
Changes.
You're too far down
you
the arm. What do you mean by snag the elbow?
In other words, if your hand goes on the elbow instead of
grab
here,
yes.
You don't uproot the guy as well.
Show me what you mean, please.
In other words, if you're pushing
I'll deflect
this,
you.
Yeah, you deflect me.
As your palm, okay, camera. So as your palm comes in, I'll deflect you. Coming in. There you go. Let's do it again.
If you grab them here,
uh-huh.
Or if you have your hand there.
Wait for me to push so you lead in.
Huh. Well, maybe.
Let's try again. So I deflect. So what were you saying?
We were saying if you're here instead of under the tricep,
uh-huh.
That we don't seem to get as much uprooting and leverage.
You want the elbow.
There. You want,
you
the,
want
elbow.
The elbow.
Oh.
Ultimately, it can work on much of the arm.
Oh.
But the elbow is your easiest purchase,
yeah.
And it's your least reach of your two options.
Yeah,
so feel the bone there?
Yep.
That's think of it just like sandpaper. You need a little pressure, but mostly it's about moving across the wood. So that pressure is the grip, right? It's not a grab, a squeeze, a hook.
Must have been something else you were doing.
Yeah.
Because there were two times that, I mean, he was getting me every time, but two times it just wasn't crisp enough.
Mm-hmm.
And both those times you have my
help. Well, I also want you to practice with a push, too. So once I'm here, I'm waiting for the push.
Oh, so maybe.
Which doesn't always happen in a tournament, you know. Too, right? But for the practice, I want to practice leading somebody's energy. That's Tai Chi. It's not grab on somebody and bend them. Like, this isn't Tai Chi. You know, if Ed starts to do an uppercut, then that should be Tai Chi, right? Just ending up in that. Like, I led that energy, that's fine, but it's not Tai Chi for me to go, I want this here, and put this here, and then hit that, and then, but that's not Tai Chi. Mm-hmm. It's receiving what's there and then leading it to better ends for you. Right? Mm-hmm. So, why don't you try with Ken, I'll do it with you, and see where we're at. Why don't you guys do it this way?
Okay.
And we'll bump in each other less. Keep looking at the plane that I'm clearly describing.
Alright,
okay.
I'll go
get
you.
No, 90 degrees to that.
Yeah, we always score
90 degrees.
Yeah.
Now, look at what I'm doing. One of you faces my hand, and one of your back is to my hand.
Alright. We're never going to be in Hollywood.
Hey, see, you can move people. You're right, you can beat. Even non-compliant people. Okay. So you'll come in with the push. If you come lower, it's more likely to aid you. If you're up high, I might not readily. That's
what you're doing, Tai Chi now.
I guess
so. Instead of just taking it, wait till I push. So my thinking is, and thinking is a strong word, my sort of pattern is likely to be, I dealt with a problem. What's my next attack? I'll try it. And that's easier if you have pressure to lead this than if I'm just kind of floating here. Then people tend to need more of a hook and more of a drag. Which isn't wrong, and it can work. You know.
More when you do it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to catch your finger, so I want to do this as if it's a block. If I just push it over there after contact, it's easier to jab. Yeah. So I'd rather clear it when it's in the air.
There you go. I'm leaving a hand there.
It's funny that you brought this up too, because that's exactly what I was thinking.
What?
And you can step.
Say you're pushing on me?
Yeah.
So if I step, I still have to step. Maybe. So you could decide you want to step a little longer to have the turn. You could decide to make a little space. You could be here. Yeah, you can determine. That's why I couldn't answer clearly the angle. Sort of depends on a lot of things.
Yeah,
so you're pushing on me, so, and then.
Often what I'll do is I'll have, watching my feet only this time, I'll have a little, right? And then keep watching the feet. So I'm drawing, I don't think I'm going to throw you, but I'm getting you challenged, and then, so it's kind of cocking, so it'll feel like that, so draw, and then, you know, I think I did that to you before, but remember, cross the line.
Space, so take a bigger stance, because you got caught, I got caught up in there. Here you go.
So where the problem is, if you overreach, you shouldn't feel great about my options.
Right.
If it works, it's great, but you're likely to fight for it and likely to have to luck out of me challenging you. Similarly, if you try and get all the way around, you're also asking this. So you have to tell yourself, this is what I'm willing. Here. As soon as it's kicking, and if the other player's good, the compromise pays off for them. I mean, I've made it work when I do it super poorly, but the other person can handle it. But I'd rather train for the best than maybe whoever you happen to meet, you know. So it's something to notice in the beginning if you feel yourself kind of reaching. So as a defense, I'll do this.
There's a step we're missing.
No, I have no problem.
Well, that reaches right there. Yeah, just reach so you know. You know, I'm baiting you into stuff.
I can't hold.
And I'll move that elbow, and I'll feel I'm looking for it. Sure. Or I'll feel and try it a few times, and then later I'll...
That's interesting.
I'll have it further than it used to be, so they think they could get it, and they're actually endangering themselves a bit.
I could do it with him with his shirt on, or with Ken. I go this way, and I can...
So you're coming up. It's saddle turn. Yeah, that's better.
But
that's
my hand still slips off.
Well, let's see, let's see. Is he staying on your chest? See, I don't want him to come off your chest so soon. Like, feel that, right? That's the base, like in wrestling. That allows you to... See, you're trying to avoid your body too much. Feel how his being on your body helps you get purchase on the elbow, lead the elbow, and then you don't care about his purchase anymore. See, you have this sense of right here trying to be out of the way. You want that. Lead, no thumb. Ken's pushing lightly, just lead. There you go.
It's really, it's almost braced against my body.
Mm-hmm.
But when we were doing it, we weren't doing the push, we were just doing it this way.
Mm-hmm.
But
it's harder to do there.
Yeah.
It's harder to do in the air.
It is.
Yeah, because the other hand is a variable, and the direction of energies in the arm is a variable. If he's pushing me, this is constant, it's stuck on me, and the energy is measurable. Like I know where he's, so I can lead the elbow easier. If his elbow's in the air, that's a lot harder to do. It's doable, but the setup is to give you an easy way to feel it and practice it, and then real life, it is what it is. Often I'll do it this way. If you go to push this, like I'll give you a little something to deal with. Even if you don't collapse it, like we're doing this, right? Da, da, da. And then I give you like I just gave you a little bit of a reason to even just think that you want to resist it coming in. And as soon as...
See, Adam Reisner guy from Australia, that's all the time.
Mm-hmm.
All the time.
Yeah.
It's like his...
Yeah. I know a couple people that can, Tom and William Chenster, this is amazing, and I know a couple of people that really specialize in the technique, and even schools where it's a real special thing that works a lot. Most people that are push hands are going to be thinking about getting you there.
Of course, like,
I really, in theory, should be thinking about getting you in any of these directions. I could care less if it's here or there, but push. And testosterone and feelings of confidence and power
toward me
lend me to want to get you there. And so that's what you're going to do. And so it's nice to develop things that like have an advantage of you coming at me. That's my advantage, you know? And if I practice with it, I don't have to, I'm not fretting over, so what, you're coming at me. In fact, I appreciate it.
Right.
There's stages to it.
Sure.
The first stage being I've never done martial arts. Later on, you know, like, come on, like, you're here. But then eventually it's like, oh, I actually want that, not that I'm ready to handle it.
Yeah.
I benefit by it, you know? Okay, how are we doing?
Good, we got that.
Okay, so next thing, let's bring this a little lower just to exaggerate. I'm going to turn you back on this camera. So as he pushes, I'm going to just remember what our setup was. Let's come back. We'll square with the lines, but that'll be better. So our previous setup was clearing across, right? So when I come in and clear across, if he clears me a little higher, or for example, this initial setup was lower, so when you clear, I'm higher, right? I'm going to lower this and lead him across, right? This time not Mona Lisa, just, you know, the corporate earnings graph, right? So as he clears me across and I'm above, or if I was close to above, I'll just help myself above, and then my elbow, my hip, all turn this way, brush knee. So instead of me trying to get underneath, which is fine, we practice that. If I'm heading over, I'm clearing. I'm not pushing 90 degrees, and I'm not pushing in the forward direction. I'm pushing behind slightly, right? That's that Mona Lisa thing. Largely, it's side to side, but there's a, you know, if I were to exaggerate it, it's here. It's not an exaggerated side to side. It's this karate kind of move. So he pushes or clears. I guess here's the clear. This is not the move. This is not the move. Just like this was not the move. So he clears me. My whole body is turning. And that's the brush knee. And if I remember brush knee, my other hand can help as I come across, which often is the shoulder. It could be the back of the shoulder, shoulder blade. But when he clears this, that's the motion. Right? So let's try that with the clear. He clears me. Now, if his right arm drops when he clears me, just drops out of the grip, I don't need it. I can just come in and do this push. It's not about me leading the arm. It's just if it's there, I clear it. I'm on top. Sorry. I'm on top. I want to make sure it's not my body first. I want to make sure it's not my arm by itself. I want to make sure I'm leading my elbow, dropping my hand, turning, the whole body expressing. Which of course means that when he pushes, I could very well make a step forward when I do that, like we might do in the form where we step into that experience. When we do white crane spreads its wings or brush knee twist step in the forms, we see one side and the other side. So when he's doing this, if he solves this, that's fine. I know the other side comes next. Normally the other side would have my feet change, but not in this game. That didn't quite work. I can come back with the other side. I'm completely happy with that. Okay? So everybody clear about that? Let's try that. I'm going to have Ed, why don't you try with Mark? Because if you leave early, I'd rather have you tire him out and let him feel you.
Okay.
Okay?
So I'm trying to...
Okay. Do you want me to do it to you, or you
yeah,
want to try?
Yeah, I'd like to see it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're here, and you deflect this, but maybe on the high side, or maybe this was low.
Okay,
this
is low.
Yeah.
This
yeah. Thing is either way, it's fine. But I end up on top.
Then I'm moving
so
really much.
So it says, "Well, the move I had was here. I'm on top. Then this whole body clears this way.
And it goes that way."
So it's kind of like both of my arms are sweeping off towards
back,
the radio.
That one's back. Yeah, yeah.
So the palm's going that way. So again, you clear.
He's got to keep the two connected.
Which is just our setup.
You're coming in with the one.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be a I could have just been in here and just decided to do it. You know.
Yeah, yeah.
Just our
yeah.
setup is that you clear me.
So that would be
here.
Yeah.
And it's not this. It's not this. It's not this. It's the whole body. You can push it a little if you want. My whole body leaving that here. I only have this to help you. It's in water.
Okay.
One more time. This is clear.
I gotta push your hand here. Put it in there. Okay.
Keep it on
yeah. In both cases, I'm leading your elbow across your open body.
Yeah.
You know, I'm leading it across, I'm leading it across, and they're both down. Other than that, their paths diverge.
So when this happens, when this occurs, and you push my energy that way, and then my inexperience leads my energy to go this
yeah.
way, so how do I
push? Are you asking for a solution?
Yeah.
Let's get it, make sure you have it, and then we can work on a solution. Alright, so I'm here, and you're coming into me, and I'm going to lead you
on
the high side. So I think that was the setup.
Harder,
yeah, it's so sad. So feel how that tightened you and lifted.
That was
right?
all
so
together. That was just one move.
Right. Lengthened, rounded, energized in the whole body.
Yeah,
is that nice?
That was 2.2.
So you felt like had the little down lead to me when you started the movement.
Yeah.
Right. You know, it wasn't straight across.
That's what we did more.
That was your body first, and your arm stayed here. Does your body first?
Too many more.
Lead it down, lengthen, rounded, full
it's
body.
It's
alright,
just like the arm a little.
So yes.
Better. But it's still the same move, right?
Remember, too, it's not this, it's this. Tom is leading, so not the side. So yes. That's this. Different muscles. Try holding a heavy door open this way or this way.
Right.
Like it's different muscles, right?
We practice the
you're tightening yourself, you kind of arm burn yourself.
I was coming over this.
Remember, you want to feel down. And lead. Not let your body lead.
So
yes, energize, round, and then this turns the whole lot. Yes. It's so easy to get here, you know, and then you're in trouble.
Yeah.
You push me. You can feel like I'm not doing the right thing. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm trying the wrong kind of thing. I push them. And then you might decide you've got other ideas once I do that. Push.
I had to do a solid.
Push.
Make it a little compact.
Push.
Kind of do a little reach.
And then I'm leading back to the side. Of course, I have this bonus other thing. I
can just do four.
Right?
Just do four.
Man. Better? Yeah.
Yeah.
You're just doing this
well. Yeah.
The form is you're losing your engine there.
Just it's hard not to like embellish it.
Oh, no.
It
yeah.
seems like.
Sorry, I forgot to deflect, sorry. So your body started before you were leading. You think about leading my elbow in the path, and then your body powers it, the whole body turns. Yep.
Yes. Yeah, I just had to do it slower.
Yeah.
All right.
Then your body went first, your lower body went first. Lead my elbow. Round. Expressed.
I think you went down to
the wheel. There's your hip kicked up.
Your power down a little bit more.
Turn, settle, express. Both of these have that down energy. Right?
That was the best one. Maybe we weren't going down and up.
Could be. I can't believe that.
Okay, so next thing, you're deflecting me, right? So you're here, you deflect, which is this way, right? So that deflection, the same thing, I could have just decided to go for this, you know. Our setup is just, it's reasonable to think he deflects me. If I end up underneath, I'm fine. If I end up on top, I'm fine. If he's low, I'm more likely to end up on top. If he's high, I'm more likely to end up underneath. But in either case, I connect, I lead the elbow, my whole body is powering that as I turn, which means I could step and turn and all the rest. So now if he leads me and I'm on top, what I like to do is just hook the hand a little bit. So I bring that hand slightly into that extension and then drive the bicep through the upper ribs to the other shoulders. So it's not this neat thing we might do in the form because I don't want to slip, but I can feel if his arm moves off my chest, I can control the arm because I have that hook. But I'm just trying to drive through what I did have as contact, through his shoulder girdle, and then out of his feet. So I'm not pushing straight across or down. I have an uproot to it. So he clears me, like so. He clears. So just that little hook. If he does something else once I'm here, I'm not going to keep trying to do that, right? So he's trying to jam me up. I'm going to lower that and brush knee. Similarly, if I'm doing the brush knee and he steps well, he doesn't just fail. Here, yeah, let me clear you so I don't want to jam your fingers. But you step to solve it. Yeah, right, let's do that again. So he steps to solve it, I can set up the same thing. Like these, the relationship of these arms, when we start brush knee, is very much like when we do G, right? They separate on their way, and they separate on their way, but they could have done this. Similarly, I could be starting this and turning into this, where he starts to solve it, or I do it, but it doesn't work, fine. Yeah? Okay, why don't you try that with Ed? That's clear?
Right, I think so.
So we don't have to do the lead, and you can just go from our arms. first one, if you're going to brush me, here, start to lead my elbow down a little, and then relax this. So the whole body connects and lead. As soon as it's your arm or your body trying it first, Mark doesn't have it. Mark's arm is trying to wrestle all the mid. So both of these moves that we did, one and two, are about leading my elbow. So your mind, besides your normal keeping in your posture and all that, has to be on my elbow.
Not push.
And lead my elbow. So if you're over, a lot of times this will happen, you'll push me and I'll clear it. You know, now that's hooking. Like that's looking for an arm lock. Just lead my elbow. Think of the shape. That's the powerful shape. Doing this kind of arm bar,
so you might do kung fu,
is a different feeling. There's that reaching, kind of an energy.
Why don't I push you straight back?
Dong Bei does that. Right now you're reaching.
In the spot.
Yeah, feel my own. That's what you want.
I gotta deflect your arm.
Keep your posture.
I'm deflecting
your arm. Oh, oh, nice. And I should be going a little down and largely over. Let's do the G.
I lean way in.
You come up on top, and then a natural G would be here, right? But it's against the cylinder. So it's a little easy for it to slip or me to slip. Or, so I just kind of have a little of this, and then find my shoulder girdle and my feet and decide the precise angle. And you'll get there, yeah. You'll get there often.
Thank you, sorry.
Yeah. Please, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
So that's kind of something to turn instead of find me. Yeah, it's better.
If you can't get out.
Yeah. Yep. And let's say I solve that, just turn into brush me.
What am I looking for?
So if you were that far over, I wouldn't re-reach. Just. So you start to solve this and just push. So I want to show you a technique. This is the first technique I beat my teacher with. And that was G, which I'm going to ask you just to solve. Right? Good. Let's do that again. So it's handshake and high five connected. Handshake and high five. Right? Handshake, high five connected. And sort of one's driving the other, just simply speaking. So that normally would look like this if he doesn't defend it, and something like this. So how I beat my teacher was doing this, and of course she solved it, right? And and then she started to solve that, solve it. And eventually I'm just tacking my sailboat. Doing this, and then I could comfortably all day, and people eventually don't solve it well. They tuck their hips, they lean, they come up, or they lose their footing, and they just want it to clear because they're thinking about the arms instead of the body, and then one of these will work. You know, it's like, you know, the water torture idea, like one of those will break you, it's just drops of water. So to be able to comfortably not overshoot any of these, and actually have them all powered and sensible, people, if you're in here, people will clear it just like we were clearing the push and just find the other side. And if you start wrestling these a little bit, like get one hand on one forearm, one on the other, you know, brush knee. Mm-hmm. You know, if you don't want these together, so you're trying to separate them doing your white crane move, like, oh, fine. I'm fine. Oh, I can bring them back together. But to me, watch G, 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 G. Oh, like, oh, that looks like my G. You know what I mean? So to feel comfortable with that, in let's do restricted step. Right, again. trying not to let that skip it
too far out.
Like a stone on the water, I'm just trying to let it stay where I want it and drive it with my body. Mm-hmm. And it's like a free point every time you do it. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have you try that on Ken. You can try it if you want, Ken, but I just want you to play him.
Okay. Oh, wait, can you do the... Because I didn't even get to do it yet.
Oh, sure. What do you want me to do?
Where you start? Yeah, whatever. No, the starting position. No.
Oh, just the circles?
I mean, okay. That, you know. Yeah, okay. And you can just whatever you want.
So just for the sake of it, when you're pushing here, mm-hmm. and you push on me, I want to have a little bit around here. Yeah, so when I'm pushing you, don't do this hooking. It's mm-hmm. really bad. Always bad.
This and then open when I'm coming towards you?
When you're being pushed on, think round.
Okay. Thank you, Mark.
It's really, like, for me, it was hard because a lot of stuff that I did uses this as a technique. It's contrary.
Try what you were learning, Ken, too. Try some other things. Try just pushing, Ken. Right. So that was good. That took him off his game. He didn't score a point, but you just decided to push, and he stopped his chess match there. Let me give you a round of playing. Right. So let's start left lead. I'm just going to call up my timer here. Sorry.
Let's see.
You good? Stop. I have change of stance. Black, 1 point. Tan, keep your own point scores. Begin. Stop. I have change of stance black, 1 point tan circles. Begin. Stop. I have change of stance black, 1 point tan. Watch the contact of the face.
All right.
Yeah. Circle. Well, it's with somebody pretty, I would have had a warning. No damage done. Circles.
I didn't put my elbow there.
Begin. Stop, change of stance, black, 1 point tan, circles. Begin. Stop, change of stance, black, 1 point tan, circles. So when you're losing there, choose a stance. You're just giving up. Right? He's pushing you, he's causing you to step, but you're not determining your own step with your consciousness, meaning you've given up. When he gets you, choose a stance that lets you fight another day. Begin. Stop, change your stance black, 1 point tan, you knew you did. That looked like close contact of the throat too. Stop, score.
five.
Did you score the
fair? That was close. He was talking me.
Close?
I don't know.
Which score?
Zero.
Good. 30-second break, switch feet when you're done. So you know what I'm talking about, right? When you change your stance and he's got you, you don't choose to make a choice about where you step. You just think, well, he got me, good one, or I'll try again, or whatever you think.
I don't think.
That's what I mean. You gotta determine, if I'm gonna step, I'm choosing my step, and you care about keeping your right foot forward, right? Similar to what I was talking about the weapons, you know, LEOs are taught, you know, to have their holster on their rear leg, right? So if they're a right-handed shooter is gonna stand this way to address you, they don't want their gun close to you,
right?
But that's a range weapon, that's different. They want it here, and they also want to be able to change so you don't see if they go to draw, right? Okay, circles, begin. Give him a match, Ken. Give him a match. Try just pushing, Mark. Stop. Change the stance black. 1 point tan. Circles. Begin. Stop. I have tan off balance. 1 point black. Circles. Begin. Nice. Stop. Thank you. I said nice instead of stop. I have black off balance, 1 point tan. And let me just put my bet here for tan, $3,000. And you're going to begin. Not too late to put the bet in as the head ref. Stop. I have black off balance, 1 point tan. Careful, that was close to an endangering joint there. You had a shoulder tangled up.
I'll pick one,
you know. It's more important the safety than the point. Circle, unless you're losing. Circles? I am totally kidding. Begin. That's nice, you chose your footwork there, Ken. Good. Stop. Time. Score.
Zero.
No, you had at least
one.
Oh, one?
I had like five or six in the first round and three or four in the second.
All right, so 8-1.
You've got a lot better.
We're about out of time. Something you want to work on or ask about or do one more time? I've just been telling you what we're doing, but you might have
a... Yeah, no, just the random experience is probably the most helpful at this
agree.
Point.
Yeah.
You know, if I don't know it, now, I'm not going to learn.
I didn't do much of this tonight with the footwork, but very often this kind of stuff, you know, with some footwork.
Give yourself.
Like if I'm here, I might use it to come a little wider. You know, I might use this to set up a push. I might clear him and then come in.
I really like the.
I'm telling you, man. I just think of it as tacking. I don't have a word for
it. Yeah, no, that like
so
makes
good.
It. Like,
yeah.
Visually, like, yeah, I'm still going straight in.
As long as, you know, when I'm tacking, I can't start heading off to a different port.
Right.
I have to have a port in mind, so it's like a drill. I can't have it kick off the wood. I have to have a direction. But so as I'm going, when you clear it, I don't want to just get cleared. I want to figure out how I just come back.
Yeah, you're never you know?
And
so
if it's no
out.
Longer the right thing, I'll open it up and I'll just push or I'll do, you know, I don't have to be married to it. But most people, it's like if you can jab well, most people can't deal with more than five jabs.
Right,
like
right.
If I can throw six really good jabs, whoever you are, I'm
one's
probably getting in there. And then if I know what to do to follow up. So I might not push you here, but I might get in and break your defense and shift your offensiveness and then be able to follow up. So it won't necessarily be this that sends them flying. Although I found for me it works fine. I didn't usually need a follow up, but I break into them, and most people can't deal with like three of them. I mean, three is most people, the second one, they're not used
already
to.
Really.
And if I can get to a third, almost nobody's got any prep. And usually by then, they're poorly defended. They've tightened and hurried and stiffened and shortened and lost.
Errors.
And then I can kind of decide, well, the right thing here is you know, whatever it happens to be, you know. But that pluck energy is a fantastic thing to be able to do, especially in restricted step where people have this narrow mindset, because they'll tend to overgo. And so a lot of times the pluck, you won't have the benefit of this purchase, because you'll be you'll be more out here. But getting that practice, even if I don't get, I don't want you to step unless you really have to. Even if I, just don't do another thing. Even if I, like, I love this, you know, we set it up tonight, like, I get you, you know, that's fantastic. But a lot of times it might be a little more like this. If I can get you here and not make errors of rules, right? And I can come in here, often I'll come in this way. So watch the technique. Here, I'm not grabbing you, but I know right where you are, and I could turn this into all kinds of things, but I love that I'm basically doing this, but it's Tai Chi, right? And then if you clear this here, right? So it works really, really nicely, but it's just, you have to be in a place that your temperament can be ready for that. Because the other person might be a bull, or have you 5-0, or have you really tired, or you gave up a couple of things, you didn't have to get up, and now you have two enemies, them and you.
Right.
And that's the sort of thing that could happen to Ken when he's taking steps in the easy step. If he, I was getting on his case, or he had coaches, or he's feeling bad, he might be like, oh, come on, Ken, and it's no time for that. Like, you're on your team, man. Not that you did that tonight, but somebody that was doing that, that can end up happening. And now it's 2-on-1.
Right.
You know. So if you can keep your composure, they clear it fine. Oh, he clears me? Great. Oh, he cleared me high? Fine. Like, I just want to keep in my structure so I can deploy, you know. Okay?
Yeah, so what is the deciding factor when you're using this technique to push, right?
Yeah.
The amount of space that's in between, or how hard you do it? I mean, what is the point where it becomes, you know, contact, a hit?
If you can hear it. If it's concussive contact. If I come into contact,
yeah,
that's fine.
Okay.
If, you know, it sounds more like a kung fu class, you know, then you're more likely, I can't say what's going to be called,
okay.
You know, I can say what I would call, and even then, that's not what's going to be called, that's what I plan to call, what I strive for, but the reality is what it is.
Right.
But as a general rule, no contact should be heard.
And does the point go to the other person, or does
it depends. If they think you're really egregious or purposeful, it could just be see you later. It could be a point, it could be a stern verbal thing, it could be a warning and a point. Usually if it's a warning to you, it's also a point to him. And then those warnings, if you get 3 of them, the match is over. And if it's a tie, but you have 2 warnings and you have none, you know, it might come into play in that regard. But I don't like to coach in those terms. I just want you to coach in the perfect world. It, you know, that's...
You can't compensate for the judge.
I'm not trying
judgment.
To do all that. I just want to not have concussive contact. But I do recognize sometimes you have it a little bit and nothing gets called, you know.
Yeah.
Like in that last, I think your last round or second to last round, you each had a couple moments where you kind of hopped, but you recovered well. Either one could have been argued, you got pushed. But I just didn't happen to call him, you know. So, and you'll see him when you look at the tape, probably, so... Okay,
cool.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You know, since it's martial arts, not theater, it's a good idea to wish him, you know, tell him to break a leg, but it's somebody else's.
Yeah. You're gonna do well.
Can one of you guys hit stop on that? Or end, or whatever? No, I'm already. No, it's fine. I got here.
Hopefully this has given us better sound too when
are
I'm
you left
using
the
this
thing. In the game?
I would imagine, yeah.
Do you have Feivu shoes?
Feivu.
You know what I mean, right?